One is exo-academic, second is pre-academic. Third thing is also there, that is known as post-academic. A person is connected with the society of learning by two methodologies. Before coming to the school or to the environment, he would have got accumulated innumerable instincts and impulses within him, which may be conducive to the development of knowledge, which may be inducing to the development of knowledge, which will be conclusive to the development system at all. He will be a medley of varieties of instincts which are salubrious and pernicious to the system of learning. That is pre-academic status. What is exo-academic status? Inside your classroom, he is having a specific obedience. Even if it is so, that obedience is doubtful. Even if it is so, that is inside the campus. So what is exo-academic? How he behaves in the society? How he behaves in the domestic? Who is the determinant? Yes, the society is going to determine the status of a person in the school and in the domestic status, or his domestic status is going to determine the character of a person in the school and society, or the school is taking to get the responsibility of determining the character of a person, how he is going to behave in the society and domestic status. Who is going to take that? Anybody who is powerful will dominate. If the society is dominant, if the society is adjacent, if the society is proximate, intimate, and mutually there is a possibility of a dual processing inside, then he will be society impacted. And how he learns from the society will be reflected either in the school or in his domestic area. If the school is so dominant, then whatever the things that he learns from the school atmosphere, that will be dominant in his reflections of society and domestic area. It may be even a conglomeration of or a composition of two or three things or all the things. And a person can develop an individual status rarely, which is devoid of, which is irrespective of any status in these three spheres. So a person can be a mixture of these three, or a person can be so strange that he does not reflect anything of these three. So, but those things are very rare. So domestic area, they are having biological affinity, number one. They don't have that. Number two, the society is having multifarious colorful presentation or projection. Society has merrymaking, it has environment suitable for recreation, it is for rejoicement, it is for rest, it is for relaxation, it is for recuperation, it is for even spoiling, innumerable things of that within the society which cannot be represented by an academy. So, education according to Shastras, I want to clearly say a golden point. Number one, biological affinity of the family is not there in the school. We have only mere knowledge tools. Number two, whatever the pluralistic recreative presentation and rejoicement of the society is not there in the school because it is rigid. The people are aliens, knowledge promoters, so they cannot be biologically affiliated. And society is pluralistic and it is uniformistic in knowledge promotion, so the school cannot represent a pluralistic society. So the teacher or the management system should create a pluralistic presentation of the wisdom model. I'm not going to bring some other thing. Even the same wisdom must be pluralistic, and they should develop a competitive or even an excellent affinity which is greater than the biological affinity, by which they can determine the character and status of those people. So they have to qualify themselves and compensate these two innate blemishes within the kingdom of academics. What are the blemishes? I have already told. Lack of infinity and lack of monotonous presentation with uniformistic motivation. So the ancient acharyas, they were 1,000 times, they were affectionate towards the children more than the parents. Matruvittu sahasrebhyopi vatsalataram shastram. 1,000 parents, they cannot equal one shastra, and 1,000 shastras, they cannot equal one deva, and 1,000 gods, they cannot equal one acharya. Because God is bifold, he has to punish us and simultaneously he has to nourish us, and acharya is only meant for nourishing us, he does not know how to punish. So that is the greatness of an acharya. This model you have to develop. These two inbuilt flaws that are there in the academics, by means of intimacy, does not require thousands of years together. Whatever, see, 20 or 25 years we are seeing the parents just submitting and showering all of their love and affection, which is within a fraction of a second. Everything is rooted by a new relation that is coming in the form of a wife or lover. It's very common. So to get intimacy, to get attraction, the time is not the mode. How do we approach? Psychoanalytical approach of a person. How to understand people? If somebody is punished, they will perish. If somebody is punished, they will flourish. You must know the model. You cannot take a single model for all people. So by comforting people, consoling people, encouraging people, embracing people, harassing people, not harassing people. How to approach the people, how to tune them so that they may be made productive is known as education system. Certainly we are going to make a syllabus for it. Very new syllabus, because only good students can become good teachers and once again reproduce good students. Isn't it so? So they need also some incorporation. Number two, there are two special skills. One is known as innovation, second is known as specialization. Most of the education systems are for just mastery, which is nowhere different from mockery. Because after finishing the exams, nobody is going to know what they have written. So, everything after the examination or the purpose is solved, everything will be Greek and Latin to people. So, this is not the real model. So, we want two skills for developing a nation. One is the skill of specialization. Wherever you have taken a subject, you have to master the subject fully and you have to get the benefit of it. And number two, innovation, to prepare new things. So whatever you have read must give you two benefits. One, you must be a specialist, having the abysmal knowledge in that. Number two, you must create something which is very much different, novel and more advanced than what you have been given to read. This is innovation. So any academy should either develop a person's innovation and specialization, or at least sow the seed for that so that he will develop it somewhere else. Elementary school teachers, they cannot couple the people by innovation, spoiling their existing syllabus. So they have to sow the seeds of intentional drive and commitment to develop their knowledge towards specialization and innovation. And number three, there are different types of knowledge and different tools of knowledge. Lot of people, they ask the question, but I have to give only a structure of it, skeleton of it. I used to say in all lectures, first we will give the skeleton, then you have to take some stuff. Then it must be covered with a skin. Then it should be invigorated by a spirit. So, a skeleton plus stuff plus skin plus spirit model is a complete model. Now, in these lectures, I am very, very unfortunate and I am confessing to say that I can give only skeletons because of the time limit and also because of the assimilation limit of the hearers as well as the patience limit of the observers. What is intellect? What is intelligence? What is acumen? What is caliber? What is perspicacity? And what is wisdom? Wisdom is a totalitarian structure of everything by which you observe things, that is known as acumen. The power that which gives you to observe things and understand is acumen. The power that which makes you to do a thing is known as a caliber. The power which makes you to advance, whenever something is growing by the speed of 2x, you will be promoted in 4x, either in vision or in vision. That is known as perspicacity. And intellect is a solid mind in which you are a good container for learning or for holding things. And intelligence is the capability to expose either in demonstration or in experimentation or in narration, in interview or in experimentation in the form of writing in examinations. That is known as intelligence. Having it is intelligence, and making others know that you have it is known as intelligence. To have it is known as intellect. And to make others know that you have the same thing is known as intelligence. And the attentive model is known as acumen, executive model is known as sharp caliber. And there are innumerable definitions which we will tell later, what is sharpness, what is shrewdness, what is smartness in knowledge, innumerable such things are there which we will know. Then what are the various types of knowledge? Innumerable types of knowledge, I have already told them, experiential knowledge is there. Then bounded knowledge is there. Then domain knowledge is there, in that domain there will be very much capable. Then distributed knowledge is there, innumerable knowledge systems are there. Likewise, there are also boosters and promoters of knowledge. Number one, one is an innate booster, I am having that craving. Second thing is environmental, is a closed auditorium. In your house, if you watch a TV, then the size is also small, you will be having a lot of